coding hernias, and this is the one I was supposed to answer. What are the steps in coding hernias? I missed this on a test question. So we've got someone preparing for their CPC board exam. And what I did is I pulled out my CPT manual, and I do a method called bubbling and highlighting. If you're not familiar with it, I think I still have it up. Let me bring it in view here. And this is my CPT manual. And in December, when I did my Blitz broadcast at Boyd Studio, this was the star of the show, the CPT manual with all the notes on it. Looks a little messy, but the concept is to group like codes together. It's typically a parent code with the indented codes and any parenthetical notes with it. So the hernia codes are in the digestive system toward the end, and the guidelines are all up here on the top. So the question wants to know how, you know, what do I need to pull out of the report to help me get to the correct code? And so what we typically do in our classes is we try and give you, like up here where I have number one, age. You want to pull that out of the report. Initial versus recurrent, you want to abstract that from the report. Is it reducible or not? And I'll talk about that in a second. And location, where is it? Okay, so that's what I have on the answer sheet here is those variables. Location or type. So location could be inguinal, lumbar, you know, the different areas that way. Initial or recurrent. If a physician is repairing a hernia that keeps coming back, then the recurrent ones are going to be worth more money. The RVU is going to be higher. But if they don't state it, then we assume initial because that's the lower RVU value one. So there's only a few instances as coders we're allowed to assume anything about the medical record. This is one of them. We need to know the age of the patient and whether or not the hernia is reducible. Now the word, this one really bugged me in the beginning as a coder, because reduce you think makes smaller, but it actually just means popping it back into alignment. If someone breaks their nose and the doctor refractures it, it's reducing the fracture. They're putting back in normal alignment. So a hernia, if they can pop it back to where it belongs, that's reducible. But if it's all twisted and caught up and they can't do that, then it's considered incarcerated or strangled, not reducible. So those are the four variables that you need to try and pull out, okay? And a little side note here, mesh, which they will normally do to prevent the hernia from popping back out in that weakened area, they'll put mesh to keep it closed. That's bundled. A lot of physicians like, there's a code for mesh. You should be coding for it. I do mesh all the time. Well, right, because they do mesh all the time, it's bundled. When they sat down to figure out the value of the code, they knew that mesh was used. The exception are these ventral hernias that I'll show you as we scroll through my manual. The ventral hernias are the only ones that are the exception to where you can bill for mesh if it's done. Okay, but all the others, it's bundled. So let's look at some examples from my manual here. So what I like to do is I like to group the parent codes. So 49491 is the very first code, and it goes down to 49492. And you'll start to see, here's initial, and it's inguinal hernia, so that's the location. And then the difference between the two within that same bubble is whether or not it's reducible. So 491 is the reducible initial inguinal hernia, and 492 is the incarcerated one. So we go to the next bubble. This is 495. This is repair of an initial inguinal hernia. So we're still initial and inguinal. So what's the difference? It's now the age, okay, of the patient here. So this is older than 50 weeks post-conception, but less than 6 months. All right, and once you're in this bubble, it's the same pattern, reducible or not. We're still inguinal. Inguinal's got a lot of codes. 49500 to 501, initial inguinal, but now it's 6 months to less than 5 years, okay, 5 years old. So reducible versus incarcerated. 505 and 507 are still initial inguinal, but now we're 5 years or older, reducible or not. And then finally, 49520 is for recurrent. So we finally left the initial inguinal. So these are recurrent inguinal hernias. At this point, age doesn't matter. Okay? So it says any age. And then my little bubbling technique, if you can't complete a bubble in the same column or page, I do the little down arrows. And then in the other column or other page, I do the kind of connector arrow up, if you're trying to make sense of this. Okay, and then 525, the buzzword here is it's a sliding inguinal hernia. Pops up over here, goes back, pops up over there, okay? And now we move into a different location or type of hernia. This is a lumbar hernia. You don't have to worry about age or all the other variables. There's just one code for it. Then we go into the femoral. We have initial versus recurrent, so 550 versus 555. And then within the bubble, it's reducible versus incarcerated. So you see how the grouping kind of helps you visually really quickly do process elimination to drill down to the correct codes. And this isn't just for board exam. It's very helpful for real world coding because it really helps you do that process elimination quickly. As much as I love using digital devices and encoders, sometimes I like to go to my manual to see it in context and see the bubbles next to each other. And then here we've got the 560 and 565 bubble. These are the incisional ones that I was talking about, or recurrent. And let's see. So this is initial recurrent. This is of the ventral. So now I've got these stars and going down to this parenthetical note. With the exception of the initial hernia repairs, 49560 and 49566, so the two bubbles above, the use of mesh or other prostheses is not separately reported. So here's our guideline. It can be reported with these two, but everything else, it's bundled. So if you have a physician that's really questioning it, show them right in the CPT manual, which is from his or her AMA association. And once you realize you do have permission to use it, here's the code. Here's the add-on code, 49568, implantation of mesh or other prostheses for open incisional or ventral hernia repair, or mesh for closure or debridement for necrotizing soft tissue infection, etc. So that's the mesh one. And then it just goes on. Repair of epigastric, reducible or incarcerated. We've got umbilical. Then we have age. And what I'll do in my bubbles is I'll put little notes in there, like the age notes, the things that I want to jump out at me to help me make a decision for a process of elimination. The spigelion or the omphalocele, those are on their own. Here's two more omphalocele bubbles. This one is large, with or without prosthesis, the removal of prosthesis, and then that's it. So those are all the hernia repairs. And they do go into some scope type repairs. So that is actually, we could probably add that as another, you know, top variable. Is it a scope repair versus open? More and more, since I started teaching this, I think there's only one scope code, and now we've got one, two, we've got four bubbles now. So the ability to do scope repairs for hernias has increased. So hopefully that will help the questioner on understanding how to code hernias. Okay.